In the electrochemistry lectures, part 6, under the chemistry lecture series, I welcome you all and I am Dr. Anima Upadhyay. In today's lecture, we will learn about the secondary reference electrodes. We have already discussed the primary reference electrode in my previous lecture and the example was standard hydrogen electrode. So today we will learn the secondary reference electrodes, that is Calomel electrode and silver-silver chloride electrode. So as we know that the electrodes whose potential is determined using the primary reference electrode are called secondary reference electrodes. But once the potential of the electrode is determined, it remains constant over a long period of time and over a wide range of temperature. These electrodes are Calomel electrode, silver-silver chloride electrode, quin hydrogen electrode, etc. So we will learn Calomel electrode and silver-silver chloride electrode in this lecture. Let us start with the Calomel electrode. We know that Calomel electrode is an example of metal and its sparingly soluble salt in a solution of soluble salt having the same ions as the sparingly soluble salt. So here the metal is mercury, its sparingly soluble salt is mercurous chloride, and the solution of ions which have the same ions as the sparingly soluble salt is potassium chloride. So chloride ions common in KCl as well as in the mercurous chloride. The half cell reaction is written here, where the mercurous chloride can either accept the electron or it can lose the electron. So we can say that Calomel electrode can be used both as anode and cathode. This electrode representation is written here, where the mercury is kept in contact with the mercurous chloride Calomel Ag2Cl2 and it is kept in the contact of the electrolyte KCl. So we can write Cl ions also and we can write KCl also. This electrode is reversible with respect to the chloride ions and the potential of the electrode depends upon the concentration of potassium chloride. It varies inversely with respect to the concentration of chloride ions. The electrode representation and the Nernst equation is written here for the Calomel electrode. So we can write E Calomel is equal to E naught minus 0.0591 log Cl. Here is the figure for the Calomel electrode. The Calomel electrode can be constructed by using a platinum wire enclosed in a narrow glass jacket, which is kept in a wide glass tube whose bottom is filled with the mercury, which is covered with a thick paste of mercurous chloride, and the wide glass tube has an inlet for potassium chloride solution, and there is another side tube which is bent twice at right angles nearly midway of this wide glass tube and opposite to the inlet for the KCl solution. This acts as salt bridge, which is also filled with the KCl solution. Once the mercurous chloride paste is filled in the wide glass tube, the KCl solution is introduced in the wide glass tube and the platinum wire is inserted, which reaches the mercury and it is sealed at the top. So I have explained the construction of the Calomel electrode and the concentration of KCl could be normal, desinormal or saturated. We prefer saturated calomel electrode because it is easy to construct. The saturated solution also is easy to prepare. Here we can see that the potential of the electrode varies with the concentration of the KCl solution. If the solution is 0.1 normal, the potential is 0.338 volts. If it is 1 normal, then the potential is 0.281 volts. And if the KCl solution is saturated, then it shows a potential of 0.2422 volts. So we can conclude that with the increase in the concentration of KCl solution, the potential of the electrode decreases. There are several advantages of this electrode. It is simple to construct. It is easy to use. The cell potential remains constant over a long period of time, and it is reproducible. And it does not vary with the temperature up to 50 degree centigrade. But there are certain disadvantages also. The calomel is toxic substance, and therefore it should be handled with care. Above 50 degrees, mercury chloride starts breaking down. So we cannot use it beyond 50. It has many applications. It is used in all the potentiometric experiments. It is also used to determine the electrode potential of other electrodes. Suppose the calomel electrode is undergoing oxidation. In that case, it is acting as anode, and it will liberate the electrons to produce mercurous ions in the solution. These ions combine with the chloride ions to produce mercurous chloride, which results in the fall in the concentration of chloride ions. The chloride ion concentration falls if the calomel electrode is undergoing oxidation. But if it is undergoing reduction, then there is a rise in the concentration of chloride ions. Because in such a case, the mercurous ions will be discharged at the electrode furnished by the mercurous chloride, which will result into the dissolution of more calomel, which will increase the concentration of chloride ions in the solution. And therefore, there will be a rise in the concentration of chloride ions if the calomel electrode is undergoing reduction or acting as cathode. So we can say that calomel electrode can be used both as anode and cathode. The other important secondary reference electrode is silver-silver chloride electrode, which is also an example of metal and its sparingly soluble salt in a solution of soluble salt having the same ions as the sparingly soluble salt. I have already explained what it means in the calomel electrode. So the reference electrode, which is silver-silver chloride, can be represented as Ag-AgCl Cl ions. Half cell reaction is also written here, and this also can be used as anode or as cathode. It may undergo both oxidation or reduction. This electrode is also reversible with respect to the chloride ions, and its potential also varies with respect to the concentration of KCl ions. The Nernst equation here, it is written AgAgCl is equal to E naught minus 0.0591 log Cl. The construction of AgAgCl electrode is very simple. In a glass tube, a platinum wire is taken whose lower end is coated with silver and then converted into silver chloride. The KCl solution is filled in this with a few drops of silver nitrate, and the lower portion is modified into a porous plug which acts as the salt bridge. Here I have explained the construction of the electrode. The silver-silver chloride electrode is constructed by taking a platinum wire whose lower part is coated with silver by the electrolysis of sodium argentocyanide (NaAgCl), and then it is partially converted to silver chloride by making it anode in KCl solution and passing a low density current for about 30 minutes. When we immerse this Ag-AgCl coated wire in the KCl solution, to which 1 or 2 drops of 1 molar silver nitrate is added, it develops a potential. And this electrode is called Ag-AgCl electrode. The effect of concentration of KCl on the potential of the electrode is described here. Here also, with the concentration of KCl, the potential decreases. With the increase in the concentration of KCl, the potential of the electrode decreases as given in the table. 1 molar will have 0.223 volts, whereas saturated KCl solution will have 0.199 volts. The advantages are very important here because Ag-AgCl electrode is non-toxic, it is very easy to construct, and it is very convenient to use also. It has many applications. It finds wide applications in the electrochemical corrosion to determine the potential of the underground pipelines and in the ship hulls. It is also used as an internal reference electrode in all the ion selective electrodes. So, this is how we can construct the secondary reference electrode. In my next lectures, I will talk more about the electrochemistry. Thank you.